Hello and good day everyone. This is Sir Dan Apostol. So kung bago ka pa lang sa ating channel, huwag mo kalimutang i-subscribe at i-hit yung notification bell button para maging updated ka sa ating mga future uploads. In this video, we are going to discuss parallel lines cut by a transversal. So review muna tayo. What is a parallel line? Parallel lines are lines that do not intersect. So kahit i-extend natin yan, hindi yan magmi-meet. So we have this line K and line L. So these are parallel lines. Line L is parallel to line K. Next is supplementary angles. Ano ba yung supplementary angles? If the sum of two angles is equal to 180, then the angles are supplementary. So yung sum ng dalawang angles na yan, yung pair of angles na yan, pag equal to 180 degrees, they are supplementary angles. So like in this angle. So yung angle BAC and angle DEF ay supplementary angles. Then yung measurement nila ay equal sa 180 degrees. And also we have the linear pair. Pag sinabing linear pair, yung two adjacent angles natin have the sum of 180 degrees. So in this example, yung angle BAD and angle CAD ay linear pair, which is nakakabuo sila ng line. So pag inad yan, yung 120 and 60, that is 180 degrees. Now, let us define transversal line. Ano ba yung transversal line? So transversal line is a line intersecting two or more coplanar lines at different points. So in this illustration, meron tayong line T and line R. They are parallel lines. Kasi kahit extend natin yan, hindi yan magmi-meet. Then pag yan hinati or dinaanan ng line S at one point sa bawat line, so ito point, one point dito and one point sa line R, etong line S ang tinatawag nating transversal line. Now, pag hinati yung parallel lines natin, magkakaroon tayo ng different angles. So, iname natin yung angles na mapoform natin. So, we have angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, angle 7, and angle 8. So, meron tayong 8 angles na na-form by the transversal line. So, ano kaya yung relationship ng bawat angles na na-form? First, let's have interior angles. So, interior angles are angles formed inside the two parallel lines. So, meaning, ito yung angles na nasa loob ng parallel lines. So, itong mga angles na to. So, we have angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, and angle 6. So, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, and angle 6 are interior angles of this example. Next is kung kanina meron tayong interior, meron naman tayong tinatawag na exterior angles. So, exterior angles are angles formed outside the parallel lines. So, ito yung interior, meaning yung mga exterior, yung angles na nasa labas ng parallel lines. So, etong angle na to, angles na to, and etong angles na to. So, we have angle 1, angle 2, and angle 7, and angle 8. So, angle 1, angle 2, and angle 7, and angle 8 are exterior angles of this example. Next, meron naman tayong tinatawag na alternate interior angles. So, alternate interior angles are pair of angles inside the parallel lines but on the other side of transversal. So, interior meaning nasa loob. So, etong mga angles na to. But, yung alternate ay on the other side of the transversal. So, meaning, hindi sila nasa same side. So meron tayong alternate interior angles, and according to the theorem, they are congruent. So we have angle 3, yung alternate interior angle niya ay yung angle 6. So sila yung mag-pair. Then angle 4 and angle 5, sila yung magka-pair. So sila yung alternate interior angles. So angle 3 and angle 6, and angle 4 and angle 5. So kung meron tayong alternate interior, meron rin tayong tinatawag na alternate exterior angles. So kung kanina nasa loob, ngayon yung nasa outside. So again, hindi sila nasa same side or nasa other side sila ng transversal. So eto yung angle, they are also congruent according to the theorem. So angle 1, yung kanyang alternate exterior angle na kapareha ay yung angle 8. So nasa outside sila pero hindi sila on the same side ng transversal. So angle 1 and angle 8. Then we have angle 2 and angle 7. Angle 2 and angle 7. So they are alternate exterior angles. Next is same side interior angles. So same side interior angles are interior angles on the same side of transversal. So kaya nga sinabing same side, nasa pareha sila na side. So interior angles, so meaning nasa loob. So meron tayong they are supplementary. Pag sinabing supplementary, yung sum nila ay equal to 180 degrees. So meron tayong pares ng 3 and 5. So they are on the same side but in the interior. So angle 3 and angle 5, and also angle 4 and angle 6. Next, meron rin tayong same side exterior angles. So same side exterior angles are exterior angles on the same side of transversal. So ito naman yung nasa labas pero on the same side. So ito yung transversal natin na hatiyan sa left and right. So exterior tayo, so meaning itong 1. Oh, they are also supplementary. So yung sum nila ay equal to 180 degrees. So meron tayong angle 1 and angle 7. So sila yung magkapares. And also we have angle 2 and angle 8. Next, we have corresponding angles. Corresponding angles are on the same position relative to the lines intersected by a transversal. It means na ito yung, kung mapapansin natin yung ating parallel lines, ito yung magkamukhang angle. So, ito yung line natin na T, pag hinati yan ng S. Etong 1, yung kamukha niyang angle dito sa line R, yung angle 5. Yun yung tinatawag na corresponding angles. So they are also congruent according to the theorem. So angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. And also we have angle 3 and angle 7. And we have angle 2 and angle 6. And angle 4 and angle 8. So let us try these examples. Identify the relationship of the following paired angles. So meron tayong line T and line R which are parallel and cut by the transversal line S. So angle na nabuo ay A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So let us identify the relationship of this one. So angle A and angle E. Angle A and angle E. So sila ay magkamukha, so meaning they are corresponding angles. Angle B and angle G. Angle B and angle G. Kung mapansin natin, nasa interior sila pero on the other side. So meaning they are alternate interior angles. Angle C and angle H. Angle C and angle H. Nasa outside sila at the same time on the same side. So meaning they are same side exterior angles. Angle A and angle H. So outside sila pero on the other side. So they are alternate exterior angles. And angle D and angle G, nasa inside sila and on, at the same time, nasa same side. So meaning they are same side interior angles. Next example is if angle 2 is 130 degrees, let us find the remaining angles. So ang reference angle natin itong angle 2, which have the measure of 130 degrees. So para makuha yung other angles, i-apply natin yung relationship na nabubuo when a transversal line cut parallel lines. So yung angle 2 ay corresponding ng angle 6, sila yung magkamukha. So meaning, yung angle 6 natin ay also 130 degrees. And from angle 6, yung angle 3 pwede natin makuha kasi they are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are congruent. So meaning, yung angle 3 natin ay 130 degrees rin. Then, meron na tayong angle 3, makukuha natin yung angle 7 kasi they are corresponding angles and they are congruent. So angle 7 is 130 degrees. And also, makukuha rin natin yung angle 5 kasi yung angle 3 and angle 5 ay same side interior angles and they are supplementary. So yung sum nila ay 180 degrees. Kung 130 degrees yung angle 3, therefore yung angle 5 ay 50 degrees. Then, yung angle 5 and angle 4 are in alternate interior angles, so therefore they are congruent. And angle 4 is also 50 degrees. Then, angle 4 and angle 8 ay corresponding angles. So, yung angle 8 natin ay 50 degrees rin. And angle 8 and angle 1 are alternate exterior angles and they are congruent. So, angle 1 is also 50 degrees. I hope natuto tayo on how to apply the relationship between angles na nabubuo ng transversal line na umahati sa parallel lines. Thank you for watching this video. Hope to see you on our next upload. God bless.